I came here last year, no intentions whatsoever to get involved with the Thai lady. One of the boys, having a good time, and it was like I'd been hit in the face with a frying pan. I met Miao, and it was just like, it wasn't love at first sight, but it was a real likeness at first sight.
I've never slept with a prostitute in Europe because I couldn't bear the idea of knocking on a door in Amsterdam and walking out 15 minutes later and that being that. Over here, you don't, that doesn't happen. You have a relationship with someone, even if it's for just 2 weeks. It's not crude sex with somebody you're never going to see again, because that personally doesn't work for me, and I know it doesn't work for a lot of the guys who come out here. That's one of the reasons they're here, because they're looking for love.
It's like a holiday fantasy, I suppose. You come to Thailand, you're here for what, 2 weeks, a month, 6 weeks, whatever period of time. You've met a beautiful lady, you're having a great time, she's told you one thing, and you know, you probably spoil your holiday to think of anything else, so why not believe it? Thailand the first time just for nothing more than a 3 month holiday with a friend. Two boys in Thailand, end of story. Got here, met Elle after maybe 2 months of being here. I'm back to England, sold everything I owned and came back. I come back because, first of all, the lifestyle. And look what we've got, it's sunny, it's beautiful, it's a paradise island. I don't have to work too hard. I got a beautiful wife. I got a great house on the beach. I stay in England for what?
Yeah, I'm on holiday. But I'm on holiday because I had a very bad time in England for the last 6 months, and I wanted to come out and make myself a bit happy. And there's no better place to come and do that than Thailand. There's a lot of hopeless romantics out in Thailand who have had their hearts broken back at home. And then they come here to have these beautiful women treat you like a king, and you fall in love in seconds. Every single man who has ever been to Thailand and had sex with a Thai lady from a bar or wherever has to hold their hands up and admit that they are a sex tourist. It's just not a very nice way to look at yourself. And I don't consider myself a sex tourist. I consider myself a come out here to make myself happy tourist.
I came over here just on the pretense to, with my two friends, to have a good time. I did not, no chance did I ever think I would go home in love with a Thai lady. I didn't, that was the last thing on my mind, because in fact I said when I was in Denmark to my friends, I am not going to get involved with any Thai ladies. I'm going to go there just to have a good time. And it happened. So I've always been a bit of a man's man, so to speak, you know? And I'm pretty set in my ways in a lot of ways, believe you me. And that's really hard to get out of them sometimes. And yes, this was a big shock last year. to my system, and not only to my system, to my friends' systems as well. They'd lost one of their drinking partners, which is a real bad shame. You hear so many stories about Thai ladies, etc., you know, and they just want your money and nothing else, and this lady's different, it's nice. As you're saying, there's lots of lovely ladies here, and there's lots of ladies to turn your head, etc., of course there is, but something just happened, and it's hard to describe. I mean, you know, as I said, I've been married before, I know what love is, and it confused me last year, because I was thinking to myself, is it love, or is it just your age? Is it just lust, or is it? And no, I've come to believe that it is. It's love. It's love. It's love. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here.
I like so much handsome man. All these, I take a go home. Yeah, go and home me. Have so many people looking. Oh, movie star. I have man, movie star. I don't care many. Only care for love. For handsome man, for take care of me forever. I have man already for take care forever. Tony.
Oh, I Tony do na.
I love him too much, na.
The first night I met El was in a bar, not too different to this one. Up here on the main road. It was basically bar lady situation. I sat down, ordered myself a beer, same as any other guy would, and over comes this lady. Hello, you want to play a game with me? Okay, we can play a game. Liked her. Went back the next day, the next day, the next day. Did that for 10 days. Eventually took her out for a meal. We went on the town together. And then kind of 2 weeks later, we were together. And that was about 4 years ago.
I have two and fan, two people. Already I'm paid snooker before already him see me. Already first time, him not like me, already look my meal. Only my meal first. Later I go play game with him, already drinking, already funny, talk funny, happy. Later him talk, you want to go with me tonight? Yeah, why not? You movie star. Just...
She was working in the bar. She hated it. She wanted out. And the only way she was going to get out was if she was to be with a Western guy that was actually going to give her some money each week so she could live. So, okay, fine.
Now stay with him 1 year. Later. Him talk me, you want to marry with me? Why not?
How did that come about? Just from love, the same as anybody else would get married. We were together for 2.5 years, we talked about it for a year, and then just did it. Why not?
I fell for Pookie because she was extraordinarily good looking. Very nice to talk to. And quite unusual for a Thai girl. She looks a little bit more European. She's quite tall. She's quite well endowed. But she's fun, and she's intelligent. She really is intelligent. She's a smart girl. I don't... Just the same way, if I was back at home, I wouldn't want to have a girlfriend who I couldn't talk to and couldn't have fun with. And I can do that with her. And as long as she feels she can do that with me, then I think it'll work. Pookie, when I met her, said to me that she would be expensive, which I was delighted to hear. But it's about 500 baht a day, realistically, plus meals and clothes and helping them out with the motorbike and buying them drinks. So pretty much like being at home, really, you know. It costs you a fortune, but only a small fortune, and it's worth it. It's worth it, absolutely. You pay them as and when they need. And normally they're quite sweet. They won't say, you give me money for... They'll say they need money to send home or they need money to buy some clothes, or and you do it that way. She told me that her grandfather was ill, so could I give her some money for that? And whether that's true or not, I don't know, to be honest with you, but that's I don't mind that. My mum doesn't seem to mind the fact that I come to Thailand, and she knows that I have friends here. She probably prefers to leave it at that. My female friends seem quite amused by the idea. My female ex-girlfriends think it's absolutely appalling, and aren't I a very sad man, and that's probably the reason they're not with me anymore in the first place. But what the hell? It's what I think that matters anyway.
Every lady come to work in Koh Samui. That's the lady to finish the family with the Thai man, because the Thai man no good for her, to hit her and have problem, don't take care in family, nothing. And every lady come here, it's have about inside, same have you sad inside, or you have broken heart or something, you have problem in family, something. You have so many people come to drinking in the bar. Must take care, and we must take care, and we can happy, we can dancing. You don't have to show everybody if you get sad inside. Not so many lady want to work in the bar, and don't want to put the light down. Same, you think about if you work in the bar, everybody think you must be bad. Lady come to work in the bar, have a problem, and the family poor, want to take up the family.
Full moon party takes place once a month over on Koh Phangan, which is an island about a 20-minute speedboat ride just north of Samui. It's largely a dance party for people to go and get off their faces, as we say in England. Everyone goes a little bit wild because they can, because they know that they don't know anybody who's stood next to them.
Western ladies. I love Western, but like all ladies, you know, there's no, what man doesn't? But I mean, but what I've seen of Thai ladies, I tend to think they like the more. I don't want to sound, what can I say, male chauvinist or anything on this, but you tend to be more like my father used to like my mother used to run after my father all the time. That sort of old-fashioned way of doing things, you know? And I see this in Thai ladies.
When Phalang man come, I think, I don't know, maybe he's so tired.
Back in England, the last three serious relationships I've had have cost me an absolute fortune. The women have been... The ladies have been particularly cruel during breakups. They've taken money off me left, right and centre, expected me to pay for everything, and still had a scowl on their face at the end of the day. The ladies here are a lot more accommodating, and they're a lot more honest and upfront. And that might not be very palatable to people back in the UK, but I think most of the guys you meet out here would agree that the ladies here are a lot more decent. They treat you better.
If you men say, Phalang lady don't care about man, but Thai lady care about man, can take care and clean and do everything for man.
It's what they don't do. It's what they don't do that makes you fall in love with them. They don't scream and shout all the time. They don't look at you like dirt if you come in 5 minutes late. They don't demand the earth and give nothing in return. And that's the reason why I fall in love with them.
Arguments aren't there, the stress isn't there, the money problems aren't there. There's nothing, she's just totally relaxed all the time. I've been with her now for, 3 years and 8 months or something, and in that 3 years and 8 months, I think I've had maybe two arguments with her. Whereas with English ladies or European ladies, every other day.
I see feminism has swung perhaps a little bit too far in the West. And because men have dared to go and try and make themselves happy instead of being constantly barracked, there is prejudice, yeah. But all we are daring to do is get happy and have some fun. Which seems to be okay for Western women, but it's a terrible thing for Western men to want to do.
Thai lady and me out. I find Thai ladies aren't so from the heart sometimes. They tend to hide it sometimes. You have to really, really work at them to actually get some sort of emotional reaction from them sometimes. Maybe it's because of a job. Also, that can't help her that much, you know, and she's got to hide her feelings sometimes. Miao, I think, just talks what I call bar English. She only knows X amount of words, I think, but she's very good at those words, and so you automatically think that she can speak good English, but when you start actually conversing with her, you do realise that she can't speak good English, and that it is a bit of a barrier when you try and talk about emotional things. And then I think that is one of the barriers. She's a bar lady, yes, yeah. And I'm quite open-minded about this, because I know she has to earn a living, so of course she'll be working when I'm not here. And this is one thing I've got to accept. Of course, it's hard, first of all, with me being there already last year for the first time. A bit of a novice to this situation, really, to be honest. So, yes, yeah, it's been hard. It's been hard trying to understand, you know, in some ways, and trying to accept. But if you love a person, that's what you've got to do. I mean, she's like any girl, so it says, I don't go with no other guys when you're not here, but you, I teach them to be out. If you don't, you don't, but if you do, I know you have to, okay? But I do send her money every month, to make life a little bit easier for her, you know? Enough money to pay her rent and things, you know, so she doesn't have to struggle so much, yeah.
I have, how many? Now, I have four men, and he write email to me. He asks about me, in love, in stay together, and in the future. He say he want to take care of my family, and my son, and me. I have to think about this man is good. I have four choice now. And one man, two men, three men, four men. And who gonna good for me? I have four choice now.
You know, they do believe that if they've just had one or two men, that the guy's gonna like them better, as if to think they're some kind of lady that just sleeps around with everybody. As for trust, I don't know how they trust. In me, with my lady, we're married now, it's been 4 years, so after you stay 4 years with somebody, you begin to know. It's a long time, every day with the same person. But with these ladies, when they're with a guy just for 2 or 3 weeks or a couple of months, I wouldn't trust her.
Cookie, who I was getting on extremely well with, has now found herself a new boyfriend. I've been in a little bit of trouble over the last few days because I found myself waiting for some money from England to be sent over, and it didn't come as fast as I thought it was going to. And suddenly, the moment I had a slight problem, we suddenly didn't seem to be together anymore. And whilst I understand that she has to make money, I'm a little bit upset that it was so ruthless and so quick. She's got someone else now who's sat right behind me in the bar. I clearly don't like that. I have to put up with it. And until I'm in a situation to rectify it, there's nothing I can do. But yet it hurts. It really does hurt. And it's no difference to being at home and seeing your ex-girlfriend with someone else. It's upsetting. Presumably when my money arrives in 48 hours, I'll probably be Mr. Popular again. I have no idea. Whether I'll want to be with her then, I don't know, because it would seem a little bit mercenary. I was determined to come out here and try to build a relationship. I came here with my eyes wide open, sadly, I've still got the same heart I had when I was back in England. And when you fall for someone, you fall for someone, and that's just the way it is.
She's got to sue the guys to make money, but I do support her a little, you know. I send enough money for every month to pay for her rent, you know. So that's okay. Maybe as the relationship gets stronger, and I see that it is getting stronger between the two of us, maybe then I may increase her allowance, maybe some money, so eventually she can not work in the bar. I mean, that would be nice for me, to be honest, because no man wants his girlfriend working in the bar and sleeping with other guys, but you've got to be realistic about it, you know.
I have 2 sons. I send money to him every month, for school, for eating. I miss him very much. I promise him I'm gonna go back home. And we're gonna have fun. And we're gonna be happy. I hope so.